much, and welcome to the show. Are you well?
Yes!
Excellent. Oh, thank you. My dad's in. No. It was lovely the way I was introduced. It's a lovely thing to get used to in a job when somebody says your name and people clap and cheer. It's really nice. It was a bit weird at the doctor's the other day. Because no one fucking clapped. Every time I said clap, I think they thought that's what I had. But like I say, I've been with my fella for 6 years. It's going really well. He bought himself a suit recently. I don't think I've ever seen him in a suit. I quite fancied him in his suit. And I told him, I said, quite fancy you in your suit. And he said, and I quote, it's very smooth. He said, if you like, I'll leave it on and sort you out all good and proper, all posh and that. He said, you forgot to say Miss Moneypenny on the end. But the only time we ever argue is when it comes to Christmas, birthdays, present-giving times, that sort of thing, because he really likes to buy me surprises, and I really hate surprises. We've got a bit of a happy medium now, though, the last couple of years, where I give him a list of pre-approved surprises. 5 or 6 things. He can pick whichever one he likes. I don't know which one it's going to be, so it's still technically a surprise. He came home a few days before my birthday last year, and he said, never guess what I've just done. I said, what have you just done? He said, I've gone off list. He said, I'm not even sure if you're going to like it. I said, why the fuck did you buy it then? I mean, thank you. But a friend of mine who doesn't really know us very well, she said, oh, that sounds like an engagement ring to me. I said, no, it sounds like kaplunk. But we have quite busy lives, as I'm sure a lot of you guys do too. And when we go on holiday, we like to go somewhere relaxing, somewhere where we can look at nice scenery and read books. That's all we really want to do. My boyfriend doesn't like to fly, so we tend to stay within the UK. And because we don't have to pay for expensive flights, we sometimes treat ourselves to a slightly posher hotel. The last posh hotel we stayed in had 2 baths either side of each other. And I thought, oh, we're going to be able to have really romantic baths together without having to stare at hairy toes. That man puts up with an awful lot with me. To be fair, his feet aren't any better. They're not horrific, they're just, you know, feet. Nails are a bit long, toes are a bit hairy. There's crusty bits on the bottoms, you know, this sort of thing. So do you look like you could pick up mice with those? They've got a certain sort of owl-like quality to them. But I live on my own. Give us a woo if you live on your own. A few of you do. You might not know this if you live on your own. You can still have breakfast in bed. What I do if I fancy breakfast in bed, just before I go to bed, I put a Twix on the bedside cabinet. And then when I wake up the next day, as my eyes are focusing, I think, there's a fucking Twix just there! But sometimes, there's just a wrapper. I've obviously got up for a wee in the night, haven't I? Either that or the tooth fairy's moved over to the dark side. I tried to start a new euphemism recently. I don't know if you've ever tried to start a new euphemism. It's quite tricky. This one's not going particularly well. I'll tell you anyway. The euphemism is this. I see there's some leftover pie in the fridge. Which is a euphemism for cunnilingus. There was a few people are explaining cunnilingus to each other. I was trying to think of a mime that I could do, but the only one I could think of was this. But I see there's some leftover pie in the fridge. Doesn't really work with my fella, because he's generally a very hungry man. As soon as he realises that there's no actual pie in the fridge, a light goes out in his eyes. I did the show in Stockton, and there was a lady at the front said, I use that euphemism, and I thought, you bugger, it's spreading like wildfire. She said she's put her own sort of spin on it. She says, I see there's some leftover corned beef pie in the fridge.
No, no, no.
If I'm ever going to refer to me nunny as a foodstuff, it's not going to be corned beef. Probably something like Arctic roll. Cold to the touch with a bit of old cake round. I've turned you off Arctic Roller, just my vagina. But I am trying to eat more healthily. I am trying. I went to the supermarket recently with my friend, and we wanted to get some crisps. And we wanted to get the proper size bags, you know, not like the little ones that you get for when Bane's around. You know what I mean? Like the proper adult bags, you know, the ones that you've got to empty into a bowl that you'd normally mix things in. My friend spotted that there was an offer on, and she wanted Doritos and I wanted Sensations because I'm a bit posher than she is. And but the two-for-one offer didn't go across brands, and we were quite sad by that. And she said, you know what we should do? We should just get two bags of each. And I grabbed her hand and I went, you know what? Sometimes you've just got to let these offers go. But I am trying to eat more healthily. I had an apple. Thank you. It's a couple of months ago. I put it in my handbag on an optimistic Monday. And by the Thursday, there weren't any Kit Kats left. And I was hungry, and I thought, I'm going to have to find this bloody apple. So I rooted around in my bag, and I found it. It was prematurely bruised and battered because it had been in my bag for so long. And it had pen on it. But I was starving, so I peeled off the clean panty liner, and I ate it. Were all right. It reminded me of something I hadn't had for years that I really liked, and I was like, what does it remind me of? And I remembered it was toffee apples. But I was having a bit of a faff on Twitter backstage. Give us a cheer if you're on Twitter. It's fun, isn't it? It can be fun. It's also a little bit weird sometimes. Got a message from a fella a few weeks ago. He said, I've got a bit of spare time on me hands, and I don't know whether to watch some porn or you. That struck me as being quite odd. I don't really know anything about porn, but from what I can gather, it's sort of fantasy, isn't it? Sort of unachievable things, isn't it? Whereas I put myself firmly in the bracket of achievable. So that man's fantasy is a middle-aged, slightly overweight woman who just witters on. Just wander around Asda, there's hundreds of me. Look along the end of your sofa, you might well be fucking married to one of me. But I clearly get this cautious nature from my parents. When I was little and I wanted to play out, my mum would say, play out by all means in the back lane, but leave the backyard door open. And every 20 minutes, I want you to come past that backyard door and just give us a little wave so that I know you're all right. And she'd stand at that kitchen window for what seemed like hours just to make sure that I was safe. And I know it's just that if I ever got abducted, I'd never be further than Gateshead. It's quite satisfying to say that my parents haven't changed in the intervening 30 years. They came to stay with me a few months ago for the weekend, and on the Sunday night, they're packing up the car to go home. And my mum has what she calls her pretty woman bags, which, you know, like the cardboard shopping bags as opposed to plastic ones. I'm glad that I know that's what she calls them, because a month before that, I'd been on the phone when she said, I've had a proper pretty woman day. And I thought, I hope you've been shopping and not just sucking off businessmen. She's retired, she's got a lot of time on her hands. But Pretty Woman for me is one of those films. I think we've all got one of those films where even if you've got the DVD, which means technically you could watch it any time you liked, if it's on the telly, you're watching it. And that's one of mine, and it was on not too long ago on ITV 2 plus 1 times 4. And you know that scene, even if you haven't seen the film, you know the classic scene where she goes back into the shop that wouldn't serve her, and she says, you work on commission, big mistake, huge. And I thought that film would have been totally different if she'd been a size 18, wouldn't it? Because I'm a size 18 and pretty much guarantee I couldn't get in any designer clothes. I'd worry about getting stuck in the fucking cubicles, let alone the clothes. She'd have gone back in and gone, you work on commission. Well, I've ordered some things online. And I don't know if they're going to fit. So I bought a handbag to cheer myself up. And I filled it with fucking Maltesers. So my mum was putting her pretty woman bags in the back seat of the car. My dad said, put them in the boot. And she said, well, I've put them in the back seat. He said, put them in the boot. Well, why can't I just leave them in the back seat? He said, if you leave them in the back seat and I've got to slam my brakes on, they'll take the top of your head off. And you'll not be able to wear your bonny dresses that you've just bought because you'll be dead. And I looked at my mum and she went, if that happens, the receipts are in the bag. Just take them back. But I had a pie the other day.
The other day?
I had a pie every day. And as I was eating it, I realised I was enjoying the pastry more than the meat. That's quite weird, isn't it? It's like somebody giving you a birthday card and they're keeping the envelope. It does make sex a lot easier, though, because if I'm horny and on my own, I just suck a condom. Oh, that's a bit too much for some of you, isn't it? But severed cock was champion, was it? So we all have our partners, but when you're trying to get to sleep, they all do niggly things, don't they? Like breathing. 30 years together, is there anything about each other when you're trying to get to sleep that's irritating? He snores, does he snore? Gives a chill to people who think that they're a snorer? Yeah. Well, the people who know they're sitting beside a snorer? Yeah. There's a bit of denial in the room tonight. My boyfriend snores, and I found out recently that my dad also snores, because I was whinging to my mum about my boyfriend snoring, and she said, have you tried these? And then slid something across the kitchen bench like it was drugs. Try these. And what they were those nasal strips. I don't know if you've seen them, they're little strips that go across the bridge of the snorer's nose so that they open the nostrils out so that they can breathe more clearly, and in theory they don't snore anymore. Now, they worked for us for a while until it came to Christmas. Now, something you need to know about me is that I really love Brussels sprouts. My boyfriend doesn't like Brussels sprouts. So at Christmas we get a big bag of Brussels sprouts and I eat the lot. And I don't mind telling you, I'm pretty fucking toxic. So just before we went to bed on Christmas night, my boyfriend went, do you mind if I don't put the strip on tonight? I don't want my nostrils to be any bigger than they have to be. Another thing he does, he puts his arm across us, and I quite like that, because I feel quite sort of safe and protected, I suppose. But then sometimes he puts his leg across, and I think, oh, now we are taking the fucking piss. The last time I did it, he put his foot, remember, I described it not that long ago, he put his foot on my leg, and he rubbed it up and down. And I went, what are you doing? And he went, I'm being tender. I said, no, love, you're exfoliating. I'll tell you a little thing and then you can all go home and take your bras off and do your belts. I don't forget about the men. I'm going to tell you another one of my euphemisms, if that's all right. Let's see if we can get this into common usage, if possible. There's a specific scenario for this euphemism. You know when you really need a poo? But for whatever reason, you can't go. It's the wrong time or the wrong place. You're going to have to hold it in maybe for 5 minutes, maybe for 6 hours, whatever. Then when you're 10 minutes away from a place or a time when you can offload, your body knows, doesn't it? And it begins the countdown. Which in my case is an almost constant stream of farts. This is where you join the scene. I'd been on trains and in meetings all day. I burst through my front door, just wanted to go on my own toilet. There's nothing wrong with that, is there? Boyfriend was in the living room. He came out in the hallway and he went, how's your day been, love? And I needed to very quickly tell him that we weren't going to be chatting straight away. So I said, I'm sorry, love. I can't talk right now. The trailers have started.
Hello, I'm Sarah Millican, and thanks very much for watching my videos. I'm going on tour with a brand new show called Bobby Dazzler. For all the information about where I'm going and when, go to sarahmillican.co.uk. Thanks.